Imagine you have given a choice between two profitable trading strategies. Both have the same return on investment, but they have different risk-reward ratios. Which one would you choose? Welcome to the world of variance in trading, a key but often overlooked aspect of the trading world. In this video, we have a look at different risk-reward ratios and see how they affect the equity curves. Stick with me and see how the wrong choice of a risk-reward ratio can ruin your profitable trading strategy and make you lose money. So, are you ready to explore variance in trading with me? Let's get started! Variance in trading is all about how much the equity curve of your account can change over time. Basically, it's a way to measure the size of the swings, or in fancy terms, the volatility. But if your strategy is profitable, why should you care about variance at all? Well, if you experience high variance, your results can swing widely from high profits to substantial losses, which not only increases your risk, but can also impact your psychology. On the other hand, a low variance narrows your returns. This can lead to more consistent results, but possibly lower returns. This means, if you understand variance, you can better manage your risk and choose trading strategies that match your risk tolerance. Because it's not just about how much you can win, it's also about how much you are willing to risk and how much uncertainty you can handle. You probably already know what a risk-reward ratio is. It's just a measure that compares the potential profit of a trade to the potential loss. A risk-reward ratio of 1 to 3, or just 3, means for every dollar you put at risk, you expect a $3 return. Simple as that. The break-even point, or the required win rate to result in no profit but also no loss, depends on this risk-reward ratio. And it's also easy to calculate. If we enter 4 trades with a risk-reward ratio of 1 to 3, you must win one of those 4 trades, which gives a win rate of 25%. So, the risk-reward ratio has an impact on the variance of the strategy performance. But how great is this impact? Is the average drawdown of a risk-reward ratio of 3 also 3 times as high as a risk-reward ratio of 1? And how about the maximum drawdown? Do these values correlate linearly or exponentially? And how the hell can we even calculate them at all? Monte Carlo simulations, named after the famous casinos in Monaco. They allow us to model the probability of different outcomes in unpredictable processes. This is useful when random variables are involved. In the context of trading, we will use Monte Carlo simulations to generate a large number of potential outcomes based on our specified risk-reward ratios. This will give us a range of possible performance scenarios from the best to the worst. I want to remind you that this is just a theoretical exercise and actual trading results are also affected by things like fees and slippage. However, this still can provide us valuable insights into the impact of the risk-reward ratio on the variance of trading performance. I coded the simulations in Python and created a simulation class that received a risk-reward ratio and return on investment in the constructor. With these values, we can calculate the required win rate to achieve this return on investment. We also used two lists to store the simulated equity curves and the drawdowns. We will test risk-reward ratios of 0.5, 1, 2, 3, 5, and 10. Each simulation starts with an initial equity of 100% and lasts for 100 trades. Then we generate a simulation for every risk-reward ratio. All of them have a return on investment of 10%. If you want to test it yourself with different risk-reward ratios or return on investments, let me know in the comments and I will give you the code. Here you can see the required win rates to achieve this ROI. A 0.5 risk-reward ratio needs a 73% win rate, while a risk-reward ratio of 10 only needs a 10% win rate. We will do 100,000 simulations for every risk-reward ratio. Simulate the outcomes based on the win rate and risk-reward ratio, and calculate the resulting equity curve and the drawdowns. These are 5 example equity curves of all risk-reward ratios. You can already spot a difference here. However, let's have a look at the best and worst equity curves out of the 100,000 simulations for all risk-reward ratios. The average of all of them isn't interesting because it will always result in the 10% ROI. You can see that the best and worst equity curves are further apart at a higher risk-reward ratio. This can also be seen in the variance. The variance of a risk-reward ratio of 5 is over 9 times as high compared to the 0.5 risk-reward ratio. And the one of a risk-reward ratio of 10 is over 18 times as large. Now, let's have a look at the drawdown. We can evaluate the average drawdown and maximum drawdown of all simulations. We can see that a higher risk-reward ratio is much more likely to experience a larger drawdown than a lower risk-reward ratio. The largest drawdown in the worst simulation of the 0.5 risk-reward ratio had only a 20% drawdown. But the worst simulation of the strategy with a risk-reward ratio of 3 had a 66% drawdown. And with a risk-reward ratio of 10, the entire account could even be lost, even though the strategy is very profitable on average. The maximum drawdown is also a relevant factor when trading with prop firms. There you often have a limit for the maximum drawdown of 10%. With these simulations, we can easily calculate the probability that you reach these 10% and lose the account. This is also called the risk of ruin. The 0.5 risk-reward ratio has only a 1% probability of losing the account after 100 trades, while a risk-reward ratio of 1 already has a 9% probability, and a simulation with a risk-reward ratio of 5 had a chance over 50%. Again, this is just a theoretical perspective, and actual trading results may vary. Interestingly, a profitable trading strategy with a high risk-reward ratio can turn unprofitable if only the risk-reward ratio is changed. This is the case when the win rate doesn't increase enough while the risk-reward ratio decreases. This highlights the complexity and unpredictability of trading. Has this analysis changed your mind about high and low risk-reward ratios? Share your thoughts in the comments. And the next time you see someone bragging on social media about a trade with an extremely high risk-reward ratio, you can show them this video and tell them that this may not be a very sustainable strategy. See you in the next one.